I was thinking about it the other day and I realized that I'm a late bloomer. There's a lot of things, a lot of milestones that I reached much later in life. And I think in some ways that can be really good for you. So if you're a late bloomer or someone who has not achieved the things that they wanted to achieve by a certain age and are worried that that means they're never going to achieve them, then I think you should watch this video. So, if that sounds interesting to you, go ahead and hit the subscribe button and stay tuned. So, if we think about what a late bloomer is, it is simply a person who achieves certain milestones that people assume you should achieve by a certain age much later in life. And if we're going by that definition, then I am definitely a late bloomer. I was a really shy kid in high school, and I didn't know what I was doing when I graduated, so I didn't go to college right away. It took me 4 years to even wrap my mind around the idea of going away to college. It was a little bit of a unique situation because no one in my family had gone to college, so I was sort of carving a path. I was the first one, and quite frankly, that was really scary. I didn't have anybody to kind of sit me down and explain what that process was like, or just see an older sibling going through the process of writing essays and applying to colleges. So it was completely foreign to me. That said, I knew that I wanted to go. I had gotten to a point where I recognized that I wanted to continue developing as a person, and I wanted to allow myself to go to a community college, take a lot of classes and subjects that I was interested in, and sort of figure out what I liked and what I was attracted to, and then go from there. And that's exactly what I did. So, right around the time most people would have been graduating from their undergrad from college, I was starting college. But here's why that was awesome. I was going completely on my own terms, and I was so freaking excited to be there. And then by the time I transferred to NYU, I believe I was 23 at the time, I again was so grateful that I was there because it was something that seemed so incredibly impossible. And I was just so incredibly grateful that I was there, that it was happening, despite the fact that I was older than most of the people around me. We have this weird concept in society. I think we have this weird obsession with youth, and somehow we think that certain dreams and certain goals and places we want to visit and experiences are only going to feel good if they happen under the age of 30. And it's simply not true. I think that sometimes when you are not achieving or getting something until much later in life, in a way, it's so much sweeter because you have struggled, because there have been obstacles in your way, and you understand what it took to overcome them. Another thing, I was really late in life when it came to romantic relationships and especially serious relationships. For myself, I think I recognized that there was a lot in life I wanted to explore, and a big part of that was moving out of my comfort zone, figuratively and quite literally, moving away from the area that I grew up in. And I think in the back of my mind, I knew that if I got into a relationship, that would probably prevent that from happening. And I think it was so much more important that I experience certain things and I get to move and travel before that happened. And so as a result, I didn't wind up getting married for the first time until I was 45. But that suited me. Understandably, if your goal is to settle, and have kids, then yes, absolutely, you'd want to get married earlier. But my point is, if it's not happening, don't freak out. I think we have this idea that if it doesn't happen by 25, if it doesn't happen by 30, if it doesn't happen by 35, it'll never happen. And that's not always the case. When I was 36 years old, I started taking swimming lessons at the Y, and I got over my fear of water and I learned to swim, right? So I would also, be very careful about defining yourself and saying, I could never do that. I think sometimes we can get real comfortable in some of our character traits that are lacking, right? So you might kind of be like, oh, I have a fear of the water. I could never swim. And you just identify with that, and that's the story you tell yourself. And I did have a fear of the water but I also believed that it was simply because I didn't grow up having swimming lessons, right? And so if you have that growth mindset that something is possible, it usually is. What else did I do late in life? Oh, Europe. The first time I stepped foot in Europe was 2009. I was also 36. 36 was a big year for me, I guess. Yes, it was the first time I ever went to Europe. You know, got my passport, did the whole thing. And I remember the first place I went was London, and I remember walking around London late at night and turning a corner and seeing Parliament and Big Ben, and I just started crying because I was so, like, I was just shaking with gratitude and excitement about being there, you know? And again, like I said, sometimes these things are incredibly moving and incredibly bittersweet. And I think, you know, not to say that if you travel a lot as a young person, you'll take it for granted, but maybe. Another thing I'll say is that I was the least athletic person in high school. I didn't do any sports. I didn't do any kind of exercise. And I started discovering exercise, basically, in college when we would start off our acting program every morning with yoga, right? So I was first introduced to yoga, I'd say, in my mid-20s. And I have become increasingly more athletic and active since then. And at 45, I, you know, got in shape enough to run my first Spartan race, right? So that is something I never thought I would be capable of. I never thought I was the type of personality to do something like that. But I challenged it, and it really, I don't want to say it was easy, but kinda. You know, it was much easier than I thought it would be, put it that way. You know, and I do not envy people who were like the star athlete or the most popular person in high school and essentially peaked in high school. I don't know that you would be as prepared because you got something early on in life. You know, my dad was in a band when he was in his late teens, and this is in the 1950s, and they actually did achieve success. It wasn't easy, but it happened. They had a hit song, they were in a Hollywood movie, they had a few records, and then the lead singer left and their fame sort of went away. And I have to say, like, achieving that early on, this would be his, I guess he was in his early 20s when it happened, I really feel like it was painful for my dad. I feel like he spent the remainder of his life trying to recapture that moment, you know? And things had changed so dramatically in the music industry and everything else. And so I know that there was a huge part of my dad that was very, very nostalgic and really regretful that he lost that early on, you know? And, you know, I think when you're a late bloomer, you've lived your life kind of either struggling or aiming for something and not getting it. And hopefully you sort of learn to manage your expectations, you learn to cope, you learn to perhaps not, hopefully, not put all of your happiness in that particular thing. And so I think of those as sort of good mental habits, right, that are going to give you a more solid foundation. So even if you do get that thing, again, you're grateful, and hopefully, you know, if it's taken away, you are better equipped to handle those sorts of disappointments. But if you like this video, you want to see more like it, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. And I would love to hear from you. Are you a late bloomer? Do you have questions about being a late bloomer? Are you hoping to not be a late bloomer and you have this timeline of things you want to get done by a certain age and why? I'd love to know all that. So go ahead and leave your comments below. But thank you for watching, and I'll talk to you next time.